Okay, so we shall continue with question 10 from tutorial chapter 3. So what we have here is we have two balls A and B, each with velocity 25 cm per second and 15 cm per second are moving in the opposite direction on a table. The ball collides with each other and bounces off. Okay, as you can see here in the question, both the velocity here is in centimeter per second. Eh? So, ini bukan meter per second. So, kena berhati-hati. This is not the desired unit kita. Alright? Desired unit kita adalah ms negative 1. So, you have to convert them to ms negative 1. And then, as you can see from the diagram, bila kita tengok dekat diagram sini, alright, your collision here, they are not meeting along the same center dekat sini. Therefore, ini is going to lead to the collision of 2D component. Sebab mereka langgar CP-CP je. Alright, bila mereka berlanggar, hujung bola ni akan bertemu dengan hujung bola ni. So, mereka akan langgar CP-CP. So, as they bounce off here, the mass of ball A and B are 20 gram and 25 gram respectively. Calculate the final velocity of ball B and its direction if the final velocity of ball A is 10 meter per second as shown in figure 3.5. Alright, so given mass, also not in the desired unit. So unit yang dia bagi adalah gram. Kita selalu guna mass dalam kilogram. Yes, so we have to convert them pergi ke kilogram. And then the question asks to find the final velocity and the direction of the ball B. So kita nak tahu what happens to the speed of ball B and the direction of ball B here, given that A is going to have velocity of 10 cm per second dekat sini. So what we have in the diagram adalah dia dah tunjuk ball A dengan ball B akan gerak in this respective direction. So sebenarnya this was not given in the question. VA adalah yang atas, VB adalah yang bawah. Error in the image lagi sekali. So betulkan dekat part sini, tambah A dan tambah B dekat bawah. So ball A moves up, ball B moves down. Objektif kita is to find the value of VB dan juga theta dia, sebab dia minta direction. So, bila dia cakap direction, it's not only the theta. Hey? You have to specifically mention where it is situated. Minta maaf lah, ada juga kan macam ni orang nak buat kerja construction kan. Give me one second. Alright, I hope the noise has reduced a little. So we shall continue here. Itu selingan tadi. Alright, back to here. So we want to find the final velocity dekat sini. Untuk objek B dekat sini. Eh? So you want to literally need the position dia juga. So what are we going to do is we're going to start with our conservations of momentum's equation. Where since it is a 2D component, kita akan ada along X dan juga along Y. So I'm going to start with summation P initial along X is going to equals to summation P final along X. Dan juga kita akan ada benda yang sama untuk initial along Y sama dengan summation P final along Y. So let us first look at X component first. So I'm going to substitute MA UA along X plus with MB UB along X akan sama dengan MA VA along X campur dengan MB VB along X. So let us focus at the masses here. The masses are in gram. So kena tukar dia pergi kg. So MA was 20 gram. 20 gram dalam kg adalah berapa? Kena bahagi dengan 1000. Yes, divide with 1000 here and then you're going to end up with 0.02 kilogram. Begitu juga MB is 25 gram. So kalau kita convert dia pergi kilogram, dia akan jadi 0.025 kg here. So saya nak masukkan MA is 0.02. UA along X component, as you can see, initially both the ball A and B are moving along X axis sahaja. Satu tengah gerak ke kanan, satu lagi ke kiri. Kanan, kiri, both is along X axis. So kita akan ada this U along X ini is whatever velocity they are initially moving. Sebab dia memang literally tengah gerak kiri dan kanan sahaja. Okay, so I can simply substitute positive 25 sebab ke kanan. Tapi dia kata centimeter per second. Jangan lupa ya, centimeter per second. Centimeter to connote pergi meter adalah darab 10 negatif 2. Because you are trying to eliminate the centi here. So nak, saya tulis dekat sebelah sini ya. UA adalah 25 centimeter per second. Kita nak unit meter per second sahaja. So you have to get rid of the centi. So you will end up with 25 centi adalah 10 negatif 2. MS negatif 1. Okay. And then you're going to plus with MB adalah 0.025 kilogram. UB along X adalah 15 centimeter per second. So 15 centimeter per second, kalau kita convert 15 centi dia adalah 10 negatif 2 meter per second. Tetapi sebab disebabkan dia ke kiri, do not forget to put the negative here sebab dia gerak ke kiri. And then kita equatekan dia dengan MA adalah 0.02. VA along X, dia dah bagi nilai of VA adalah 10 cm per second. So 10. And as you can see, dia tengah bergerak dekat sini. Eh. This is your VA. So kalau kita ambil VA along X, dia adalah to the left here. To the left. So dia akan ada direction ke kiri negatif. VA along X. VA along X adalah 10 darab 10 negatif 2 senti. Eh? This is the conversion for centimeter. And then kita ada cos 35. Right? And then you're going to plus with 0.025. Bracket saya sama dekat bawah sebab tak cukup tempat. No. I'll do this. I'm going to smallkan kawan ini. Dia ke sini. Alright, now we have enough space. So kita ada VB along X. VB along X, as you can see here, VB along X pergi sini. VB kita tak tahu, theta pun kita tak tahu. Kalau saya, saya tak nak kembangkan dia. Saya biar dia sebagai VBX sahaja. I'm gonna leave it as VB along X. I'm not gonna open it as VB cos theta. Tak nak, sebab dia ada dua unknown. Saya nak biar dia macam ni sahaja. Then what you have to do next is press your calculator. 0.02 multiply with 25 exponent negative 2. Terdapat ini sebagai 5 darab 10 kuasa negatif 3. 0.025 times 15 exponent negative 2 minus sebab ada negatif 3.75 times 10 to the power negative 3. Samakan dengan do your max. Exponent negative 2 cos 35 multiply with 0.02. So this one becomes negative 1.64 times 10 to the power negative 3 plus with 0.025 VBX. Right? We good here. So I'm going to simplify all this. 5 exponent negative 3 minus 3.75 exponent negative 3. I get 1.25 exponent negative 3. And then ini rewrite balik. Plus with 0.025 VBX. So I'm going to bring this one to the left. Sebab dia negatif, bawa ke kiri dia jadi tambah 1.25 exponent negative 3 plus 1.64 exponent negative 3. Should get 2.89 times 10 to the power negative 3 equals to 0.025 VB along X dekat sini. So to find VB along X, kita bahagi dengan this one dengan yang ini. So ini bawa ke sini bahagi. So you divide 0.025. So you should end up with 0.1156. Okay, ini adalah nilai VB along X. Okay, ini adalah nilai VB along X. Kita nak VB sahaja. So biar dulu. Tak ada masalah. And then kita masuk X component. Y component pula. Untuk Y component, summation P initial along Y dan sama dengan summation P final along Y. So I'm going to end up with MA UAY plus MB UBY equals to MA VAY plus with MBVBY. So initially, your object does not have any motion along y-axis. Dia tak bergerak atas bawah. Tak ada pergerakan along atas bawah. So kita letak kosong terus. MA adalah 0.02. VA along y. So you can see this is your VA. VA along y ke atas, positive. VA sine 35. Right? VA sine 35. VA adalah 10 meter per second tadi. Centimeter per second. So darab 10 negatif 2. Sine 35 here. And then plus width MB adalah 0.025. And as you can see here, your VB ke sini. So if you want to find your VB along Y, dia akan turun ke bawah. So ke bawah, kita masukkan siap-siap the negative sign. Saya tak nak kembangkan juga. Saya biar dia sebagai VB along Y dekat sini. So as you press your calculator, 10 eksponen negatif 2 sine 35 multiply with 0.02, you should get this as 1.147 minus with 0.025 VB along y. This is 0 here. So I'm going to bring this one ke depan. Pada negatif, dia akan jadi positive here. So kita akan dapat 0.025 VB along y sama dengan 1.147. So jadikan VB along y subject bahagi 1.1. Sorry, dia ada 10 negatif 3 tadi. Saya taruh tinggal. Darab 10 negatif 3. 47 eksponen negatif 3. Divide with 0.025. You should get 0.04588 as your VB along Y. Okay. So you can see. Soalan minta VB dan juga the direction. Okay. So what I have here is my VB along X adalah sebanyak 0.1156. MS negative 1 dan juga VB along Y adalah 0.04588 MS negative 1. So from here I can actually find my VB, iaitu menggunakan kaedah magnitude, iaitu VB X square plus VB Y square. This is why I did not kembangkan tadi. I leave them as VB X and VB Y as I want to use this equation to find my VB. Alright, so saya masukkan dekat sini 0.1156 square plus width 0.04588 square. Square root semua. Square root, we will end up with 0.124 ms negative 1. This is your VB. Alright, dah dapat VB. Tinggal nak kena cari the theta shift tangent summation 0.04588 divided by 0.1156. You should get your answer such as 0.04588 divided 0.115 shift tangent. You should get 21.7 degree. So this is what you got here. Right, 21.7 degree adalah theta dia saja. Kita nak tahu direction. The question states that direction dekat sini. So, dia berada, this is your x-axis. Dia berada di bawah x-axis. So, dia akan ada, the direction would be below positive x-axis. This is how you should write sepatutnya. Very good. Okay. Kalaulah kamu nak kembangkan ini VBX dengan VBY pun boleh, tak ada masalah. Boleh saja. You can also kembangkan them become, saya guna pen merah, VB cos theta. Ini akan jadi VB sin theta. So what happened here sebenarnya, bahagian sini kamu akan ada VB cos theta. So this whole thing is actually your VB cos theta. Benda yang sama juga. This whole thing akan jadi VB sin theta adalah 0.04588. Boleh, tak ada masalah, sama. So tadi VB cos theta adalah 0.1156 dan juga VB sin theta adalah 0.04588. 8. And then I have talked about this dalam kelas tadi. Tangent theta akan sama dengan sine theta over cos theta. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to divide these two. VB sine theta bahagi dengan VB cos theta. I'll get 0.04588 bahagi dengan 0.1156. Okay, VB akan cancel. Sine theta over cos theta dapat tangent theta. So 0.04588 divide with 0.1156. I get 0.397 lah. And then shift tangent answer. You should get theta kamu sebagai 21.6 degree dekat sini. Are we good? Okay, dah dapat theta. Apa kita boleh buat? Masukkan balik dekat salah satu equation sini untuk dapatkan VB. Let's say VB cos 21.6 is equals to 0.1156. VB akan jadi 0.1156 divide cos 21.6. Awak dapat 0.124 - 1. Sama juga. Alright, boleh kembangkan, tak nak kembangkan pun boleh. Alright.